The Story of Mud Part 3. In the previous video, you had learned about the soil properties. Soil is the elixir of life. Without soil, trees and plants cannot grow, nor can a farmer cultivate. We also learned that there are minerals, stones, insects, etc. in the soil. In this video, we will learn some more aspects of soil. Let me take you to Wayanad in Kerala. Here, Biju is playing in the mud with his sister Sheena. The objective of this video is to know about soil moisture and water absorption capacity by different types of soil.
There is so much fun playing in mud.
And look, I brought some sand too.
Let's build houses from this sand and make dolls with clay.
Look here, Biju. A house made of sand is crumbling again and again. There is not much wetness in this sand. Add some more water. Let us see if this makes the house stronger.
Let me try adding some water, because if it becomes too wet, like clay, then this sand house will get spoiled.
Look, Biju. What a nice sand house I made.
Children, come early and have dinner. You both have to go out in the evening.
Come on, Biju. Mother is calling. Wow, what a nice toy model you made out of the clay.
How sticky the hands have become. Let's wash them with soap. I shall keep this toy with your sand house to dry. Sheena, your sand house broke again. And look here, there is no moisture in this sand. Looks like that was the reason the house broke again.
Your toy is not broken, Biju. But look, this toy is also drying up. It seems the moisture is running out.
You are right. They were both in the sun. The sand house broke down and my toy is still drying.
You must have noticed that when it rains, our yard becomes wet and after a few hours, everything dries up.
Does this mean there is moisture in the soil? Does this moisture dry out due to sunlight or heat?
Yes, there is moisture in the soil.
Come on, children, rest a while. You have to go to the flower shop in the evening.
Come, let us go inside. Mother is calling.
While the children are resting, we shall perform a small experiment. Take two glasses, put some soil in both of them. Keep one glass aside. Take another glass and boil it for a while. What do we see?
Kids, get ready soon. The flower show is open only till 8 o'clock.
Father, we are coming. Hurry up, Biju.
Father, today we were playing with mud. We made a toy out of clay and we also made a sand house. But we saw that our sand house broke and the clay toy almost dried up. Why would this have happened?
Soil contains water. This causes moisture in the soil. Just as we need water, the soil also needs water.
Trees and plants grow, isn't it?
Yes, plants get nutrients due to the water in the soil.
Due to water, trees are green and vegetables, fruits and flowers also grow, isn't it, Father?
Yes, through water, plants get dissolved nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium and calcium, etc., which reach their roots, then the plants get nourishment from the roots. Look, we have come to the flower show. Here you will find different flowers, plants, seeds.
Wow, look at these beautiful flowers!
And see how many different varieties of plants are there here.
You both stay here. I will just come.
Biju, look at this. All these flowers are looking so beautiful.
Sheena, something is written here.
It is written here that these flowers have grown in different types of soil.
Hello children, my name is Cosmos Flower. And do you know I grow in sand?
This flower is talking.
You know, the sandy soil in which I bloom doesn't have enough water absorption capacity. Therefore, a lot of air is present in this type of soil. It's hard for me to grow. Well, yet I try. Look how beautifully I grew. That is why I have been exhibited in the flower show. Children, would you like to take me home?
The water holding capacity of the soil of this flower is very less. This flower is so beautiful and it does not need much water. I want to take this flower home.
Children, you look at me. I bloom from early spring to mid-summer. I bloom in various colors, from white to pink, red and yellow. You know, I bloom in clay. The water holding capacity of this soil is very high. You can also make toys with this wet clay. This soil is present everywhere. Take me home. This soil is rich in organic materials.
This flower is nice too. But its soil water holding capacity is quite high. So this flower needs more water. Biju, shall we take it home?
Children, I am the best. The soil in which I bloom is called loamy soil. This soil consists of sand, clay and silt. It also contains enough humus. Its water holding capacity is good, not more and not less. This soil gets enough air. It is well suited for farming. Due to this soil, the roots of plants get enough space for water, air and growth. I also bloom everywhere. Take me home.
Oh God, there is a fight between these flowers. What to do, Biju? Where is father? Let us ask him.
To whom were you two children talking to?
We weren't talking to anyone, father. We are unable to decide. So, you tell us which of these three flowers you liked. We will take the same flower home.
I liked all three. Let's take these three home.
Was that less fighting among us?
We three, alas.
Children, in this video, you have learnt about moisture in soil and water holding capacity of different soils. Hope you have liked this video. In the next video, you will learn about soil and crops. See you!